Okay, good morning students. The previous topic I will continue today, which is dimensioning. So dimensioning is most important things in the engineering drawing, or you can say that the dimensioning is the most important part of anything. Like when you're going to fill any form, after that, after your diploma, so what happened? Your height and weight is essential to enter. Okay, why is needed? Because on the basis of that, your doctor, when you meet the doctor, then what happened? Your height and weight is mandatory, so they can measure your height and weight. Means it is a dimension of you. What is your dimension? So what is your height and what is your weight? According to that, the doctor prescribe you medicines, so that without any dimension, you can't able to manufacture any component. Okay, so dimension is very required, and these dimensions we can make notations for that. And these dimensions show what are the diameter of the circle, what is the radius of the earth, what is the length of the particular line, what is the width of particular line, okay, what is the surface texture of the component. So these are the dimension point of view. So these are very essential to the measure. So indicating on a drawing the size of the object and the other details essential for its construction and function using line, number, symbols, notes, etc. Dimensions indicates on a drawing should be those that are essential for the production, inspection and functioning of the object, and should not be mistaken as those that are required to make a drawing of an object. So act like you see in the diagram, there is dimensioning is given. Okay, so dimensioning is provided from a reference point or reference edge. Okay, so in this diagram, the reference edge is this side. Okay, so all the dimension belongs to reference this side. So here to here distance is S, here to here distance is P, here to here distance is S, this total is S, and now P, P and P. So what happened? You can see. So we choose minimum possible view, which is required to represent all the dimensions in the drawing. Okay. So that isometric view is given the maximum detail of the drawing. But what happened? For the manufacturing purpose, isometric view is not required. Here use two-dimensional drawing, or we can say that orthographic drawings. So that in orthographic drawing, there is six principal views: front view, top view, side view, right hand side view and left hand side view, back view and bottom view. So there are total six views which is required to represent the orthographic projection. But out of these six, we choose minimum projection or minimum view which is required to represent all the dimension of the component. It means we can choose 2, 3, whatever there, by which we can represent all the dimensions in the component. Okay, So here you can see there is a plate, and in the plate there is three hole. So we don't need to represent each and every hole. Okay, so what happened here? Here is a hole of S size and drilled. So three hole is there. So all three hole is same size. So there is no need you can represent the dimension of all these things. So you can represent one hole dimension and put here three holes. Means in the component there is three hole of this size. Okay, so here unnecessary dimension is showing you. What is that unnecessary dimensioning showing you? P. So we don't need this dimension if all this is given, or we can represent like this, the total dimension and these three dimension. So we can find out this dimension to subtract this dimension from this total dimension. So for the representation purpose, we also choose the optimal number of dimensioning. Okay, so here this dimension is unnecessary, so we can remove this dimension. Now you can see the minimum view which is required to the representation of the drawing and dimensions. So most of the simple geometry is two view is required to represent the all the dimensions. Like here in a diagram, what happened? The front view and top view is given. B also front view and top view is given. In C, front view and side view is given. And similarly in the D, front view and side view is given. So that we get the two dimension from the front view, two dimensions means length and width from the front view, and height or thickness from the top view. Length and width from the front view and thickness or height from the top view. So you can represent like this, means in left hand side and top, or right hand side and top. Okay, so these are the examples. You follow anyone, you can follow anyone. So size dimension, given the size of component solid, every solid has three dimension each of the geometric shape. Making up the object must have its height, width and depth indicate in the dimensioning purpose. So here you can see what are the basic geometric shape used in the drawing. Okay, this is the angle, right angle, this is your triangles, this is a square, rectangle, rhombus. So these are the polygons, these are the regular solid, prism. So different type of solid and geometries which is used in the geometry in engineering drawing, that is visible in this figure. So now what is in the prism? Prism is the most common shape in the engineering drawing, required three dimensions, give two dimension on the front view and one dimension in the top view or side view. So like cylinder, what happened? In front view you can see what are the dimension. Means for the cylinder, one view is sufficient. But for the better presentation, we draw the two view of the cylinder. Means what happened? The diameter is represented here, the dimension of diameter is represented here, and the length of the cylinder is represented here. So there is no need to draw this. But what happened? What is the shape of this? What is the shape of the top view? That is not clarified from this front view. What is the top of the cylinder? That is not clarified of this front view. So that we need top view to recognize or identify what is the shape of the top. Okay, so because if we don't draw the top view, then what happen? There is no difference between prism and cylinder. See, top view is a square. Okay, here top view is circle. So this is your prism and this is your cylinder. That is the difference. That's why, because two dimension, cylinder need two dimensions and prism need three dimensions. So two dimension is represented in the front view only, but the top view drawn so that we can recognize that this is prism or cylinder. Okay, similarly front view and side view, front view and side view. If cylinder is laid down on the surface, so similarly you can see these two. So what happened here? You can see what happened here. What is the difference between A and B? What is the difference between A and B? Okay, this is the dimension representation, but this one is correct, but this one is poor practice. But meaning is that this is not wrong, but this is the poor representation. The good representation is like that. Okay, you also present like that, but the good presentation, good practice for this, we can represent the size between length or distance between these two centers by this. So locating the hole like that. Now in this, what happened? 1/2 drill, 5 hole, equal spaced. So what do you meaning of that? The meaning of that, there is 1/2 drilled hole and total 5 holes is there with the same size and same space. Means between two hole center, that angle is same, equally distributed. Okay, now see what happened. 1/2 drill, 4 hole. So it is not equally distributed. So there is not written equally distributed. This is 4 hole of same size. So that this will be appear. Equally distributed means we can divide the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hole. So we can divide the 360 divided by 5. 360 divided by 5. Then what is the meaning of that? So that what happened? 360 divided by 5, so that 72 angle between these two axes of the hole. Okay, so here this is not equally distributed, so this angle must be given. This angle must be given. So between these two angle is here between from the vertical axis, the distance of this, and from the vertical of distance of this. So we can recognize this. Now similarly here, what happened? The three hole is there with the same diameter, but the location is represented by the in term of the length or distance, in the term of length and distance. Here represented by the angle. Here equally distance, then we can easily calculate the angles between two angle between two circle centers. So there are three representation for the dimension of the same fashion, equally space, four hole, but the distance between two holes given in the term of angles. But here what happened? The distance between two hole is given by the vertical and horizontal distance. Means this hole center is 2.334 from the horizontal and 0.896 from the horizontal and 2.334 from the vertical. So from the vertical axis and from the horizontal axis, the distance is given for particular hole. Similarly from here, this distance from the horizontal and this distance from the vertical. So you can see the same things we can represent in the different manner, and all the method are correct. But what happened? From this one and this one, we choose this one because here we have to write more, because for one single point we need two dimensions, from the horizontal and from the vertical. So from here we just need one angle dimensions. Okay, so this one is better in comparison to this, but both are correct. You can choose anyone for the representing the distance between two holes in circular manner. Now what happened? See, there is representation of dimension of hatching component. So this is the best representation, and we can choose this one too. We can choose the B2, but this one is totally wrong. This one is totally wrong. We can draw a line and upside we write one and downside we write two. So this is totally wrong. We don't choose this type of presentation of dimension. We can choose this one. This one is the best and this one is okay. This is correct. So here you can see 2, 7/16, the total dimension. Then between this dimension and this dimension, this is the good practice, preferable, and you represent like this. So what happened? You write the dimension if this fashion, then what happened? This is look like overlapping the dimensions. Okay, and there is some confusion to understand or read the dimension. So we can prefer this one. We can prefer this in comparison to this, but both are correct. I don't say that this is wrong, but this is poor representation. The identification of dimension is poor in this. Now this is the dimensioning of arc. How we dimension the arc? how we dimension the arc. So see here, represent the center and length of the arc. So this is 1.12 arc like this. We represent like this B, and we also represent like this, means the center point is not shown here. Okay, and we also represent like this outside of the arc. This is, these are the inside of the arc, these are the outside of the arc. So see here, we can represent like this too. Okay, so this is your positive, this is your negative. So what happened? If long arc is there, or long radius is there, so we can also represent like this. Okay, we just represent the zigzag line of the dimension of the arc. So we can choose any one of these to representation of the arc. Now see here, you can see the dimension of the radius. Okay, this is arc. I already told you, when the in the diagram the complete circle is there, then we can represent by the phi. Phi is the representation of the diameter, and diameter is available in the circle only. Diameter is available in the circle only. If phi is written in the front of any number, then it is the representation of, there must be a circle diagram in the particular projection. So see here, 5.50, it means there is 0.5 circle is there. There is R represent the arc, means this is not complete circle, this is the semicircle. So phi 1.0, see here, this is phi, and R, this is the arc. Okay, see here, the dimension of this big circle is not given, it is given in the front view. So see here, so that's why phi is there. That's why phi is there. So phi is meaning the circular shape is there. Complete circular shape is there. That's why phi is given here. Okay. So what is the meaning? You have to know the representation of the symbols. What the symbols represents. Because as much important you draw the drawing, as much important you draw the drawing, similarly it is most important that you have able to read the drawing. Okay, same things is there. You draw the drawing, if you are good in engineering drawing, then you have both the knowledge. You are a good in engineering drawing, as well as you can read the drawing properly. So what is representation of the this drawing? So there is, from the axis there is a rectangular part, in the bottom of the rectangular part there is a semicircle which radius is 0.5, and in the center there is a circle hole which diameter is 0.5. and what happened, the second end of the rectangle closed by the a semicircle which diameter is 1. Okay, and in this corner there is two hole. See, the diameter of these two is 1.5 and 1. So you can see, so what you see here, you will see, able to see here, there is a hole. Throughout hole is there. By this dotted line. By this dotted line. Okay. So, there is a extension of the material. Okay. So, in that, there is a throughout hole of one diameter. And here is what this line representation, this line is the hidden line from this semicircle. So all these information is not written here, but you are able to read this because you know the symboling and dimensioning of the engineering drawing, so that you can easily read that. Now from here, dimension inside the view. So inside the view we can represent the dimension like that. So you are able to see that all the dimension we can represent the inside of the drawing. Why this system we can adopt? We can adopt this system when the size of the sheet is not sufficient. Okay, the whole diagram is covered the your drawing sheet, so we can adopt inside dimensioning of the component. So there is no need much more space because external system of dimensioning is required more space, but when we provide the dimension inside the component, then it is take the less space in the representation. So like that, what happened? We choose like this. So what happened here is the unnecessary things is there, because here is three dimension, but we can represent these things by two dimension only. So we can avoid this. This is not incorrect, but this is the poor representation of dimension. Total dimension and this dimension. So we can definitely find out this dimension by subtracting this dimension to this total dimension. Okay. So there is no need to you represent the all three dimension is here. We easily represent the two dimension and we can easily find out the third dimension by calculating them. Now, value midway between arrow. So what happened? This. So what happened? Here is, it is not in the midway. So if it is possible, then we can provide the value of the dimension in the midway of the arrow. Like these two. These are the in the midway. So you can ask me a question from the previous slide. Why this is incorrect? I don't say this is incorrect, but it is the poor representation. And in that situation, if we give the dimension in the midpoint of the arrow, then it is the confusing to read the dimension. So from this diagram, that is good, we can avoid the dimension in the mid of the arrow. But for the practicing, we can choose the like this. If a dimensioning is like this, then we can easily choose the midpoint, because from the midpoint the overlapping is not there and we can easily read the dimension of the drawings. Now you can see how we represent. This is two values suggested for the clarity. Okay, so clear things is here. Same things like represent. See here, it is mid way selection, but it is what happened. We now choose midway because the shake of the clarity. Okay, if we choose midpoint, then all the dimension in the here. So what happened? The clarity is not good. So that in that case, when midpoint is same for all the dimension, they we can choose the different location for the dimensioning. If all the dimension come in the same line, midpoint is come to the same line, so you choose different location to represent the dimensions. Now representation of cone. So cone required two dimension, diameter and base. Cone required two dimension, diameter and the base, and altitude on the same view and length both are shown properly on the rectangular view. See here, this is the cone with the center hole. See, you can see the all dimension in the front view, but for the representation we need top view here. Similarly, right pyramid, so top view is required for the shake of the dimensions, dimension of the base and altitude here. So maximum dimension here we can show in the top view. Now dimensioning suggested for this component, so the total dimension is there. Okay, so the total dimension from here to here, so we can find out this dimension easily, there is no problem. And this dimension is not given, so we can find out this dimension to subtracting these three dimension from this total dimension. So easily find out, there is no unnecessary dimension is provided, so we can avoid the unnecessary dimension in the component, for the component. So we choose optimized number of dimensions, optimized number of view, which is required the proper dimension and the proper size and shape. So this is about the sphere. A sphere required only one dimensions, that is diameter. So we can so like this, sphere required only one dimension, but what happened? It is cut from the distance, so we need to top view for better representation. Location dimensioning, after the basic geometry shape have been dimensioned for the size, the location of each relative to the other must be given. Location must be established in the height, width and depth direction. Rectangular face are positioned with reference to their face, cylinder and conic shape with reference to their center line and their ends. Now size of the location you can see this is the complete drawing. This is the complete drawing. So minimum, texting is required. So I can explain you. I can explain you. You see this in the proper way. Okay. Now the distance of two. This is very good. Now this represent the threaded area, the threaded hole. Inside threaded hole, the diameter, the threaded diameter is 0.005, and the location is A. Okay, now this distance, and there is a hole of 0.15 through. What is the meaning of through? Meaning of through is this hole is throughout the component. This hole is throughout the component. So that's why through is written here. Through is written here because this hole is throughout the component. Okay. So now 5.20 through and two place. So what happened? There is a diameter of this hole is 0.2 and throughout the component, and the position is 2, means this hole in 2 position in the component. So there is no need to explain the dimension of this hole because the dimension of both the hole represented here. So there is no need. So now see here, 5.3 means what happened? The diameter of this hole is 0.3. And this is not through. This is the 0.25 deep. 0.25 deep. See? 0.25 deep. Okay? And two places. So, same. There is two places. One places and two places in the component. So, this represents that there is no need to dimensioning this two. Okay? So all the things is written here. There is a chamfer, and chamfer angle is 45 degree, and the length of the chamfer is 0.1. So it is representation. Any texting is given? No, there is no texting. But why I am able to read this drawing? Because I know the symbols and dimensioning method of the engineering drawing. So you also know, so you also able to read this drawing. There is no need to texting. Okay, now terminology for the dimensioning practice. Dimensions, numerical value that's defined. The size are geometric characteristics of a feature, size 3.5 and space between, line of text 1.5 mm. See here. Okay, dimension showing the size of the feature such as width, height, depth, and the part of the diameter of the hole. Dimension showing the location and orientation of the feature such as location of the center of the hole. See, center of the hole. So positioning is defined. So we can represent this angle. So find out this taper. What is the taper position of this is? We can find out the by the angle. Basic dimension. A number value define the theoretical exact size of a feature. Reference dimension, a numerical value enclosed in the reference provide for the information only and not directly used in the fabrication of the part. It is a calculated size used to show the intended design and size of a component or part. So, dimensional line. A thin solid line that show the extended and the direction of a dimension. Dimensions line are broken for the intersection of the dimensions number. See the dimensions here broken to represent the what is the length of this, and see 13, 6 mm minimum. So what happened? Between here you can see between two dimensions line, between two dimensions line which is parallel to each other, between two dimensions line which is parallel to each other, minimum 6 mm distance is required. Between two dimensions line which is parallel to each other, minimum 6 mm dimension or distance is required, and there is minimum 10 mm distance from the object line. Minimum 10 mm distance from the object line when we represent the dimension of any component. So should be placed at least 10 mm away from the outline or object line. All other parallel dimensions should be at least 6 mm apart or more if space is permitted. Minimum is 6 mm. You provide the more space if your drawing sheet is allow the space, then you can choose more than 6 or more than 2 for the representation. So now here is the dimension of the arrow. Dimension of the arrow 3 mm wide, and the should be 1/3 as the wide as they are long. See here, this is W and this is 3W. So many of the competitive exam when the interview is scheduled and you are belongs to the drawing or belongs to design, so this question is asked, what is the dimension of the arrow of dimensions line? What is the dimension of the arrow of the dimensions line? So this is the representation. If width is W, then length of the arrow is 3W. Now extension line. What is the extension line? A thin line, solid line, perpendicular a dimension line, indicating which feature is associated with the dimensions. Okay, so extension line and dimension line is used together. Visual gap. There should be a visual gap of 1.5 mm between the feature corner and end of the extension line. Ladder line. A thin solid line used to indicate the feature with which a dimensions nodes or symbol is associated. Generally a straight line. Generally a straight line drawn at an angle that is the neither horizontal nor vertical, trimmed with an arrow touching the part of detail. On the end opposite the arrow, the leader line will have a short horizontal shoulder. Text is extended from the shoulder such that the text height is centered with the shoulder line. Diameter symbol, I already showed. Phi is the diameter symbol and radius symbol is the R. So here you can see this is the dimension line, this is the extension line, this is the arrow head, and here is the notes. So what is the notes? Notes is 12 mm diameter, two holes present in the component. Okay.